So, today I'm at the Virginian Golf Club. It's a Tom Fazio design, and it's a personal favorite, so it's really good. But today I'm just going to show you guys a putting drill that I do. I learned it recently, and I just love it. So what you're going to do is you're going to take your putter, and you're going to put it near the hole and put a tee down. And that should be about 3 feet, and then you're gonna go another putter, so you end up at 12 feet. So then it would be another putter, 6 feet. Now, I've had a lot of comments on YouTube asking me to do a complete range session, so today I'm gonna do that. Now, it's taken me a while to get this done. I haven't been able to do it because I don't get enough balls at the practice range like practice at. But now my good friend, Connor, member at the Virginian here in Bristol, Virginia, has extended me privileges to hit on the range and hit unlimited balls. So I'm gonna be able to do that today. A lot of you guys may not realize, but that I am not a member at any golf course. So I really never get to play unless I play with the high school team. So it's a really good opportunity to come up here because I get to play with Connor a lot. Now, I'm gonna go over here and start my range session. What you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna try and find the hardest putt. So it's a challenge. It's not an easy uphill, dead straight putt, because then there's no real purpose. Well, there's still a purpose, it's just not challenging yourself. So you're just gonna put a ball near each tee. And the objective of the exercise is to try and make 16 putts. So, and the lesson is to have a feel for your stroke and not guess on every putt you have. So, what you're gonna do is you're gonna putt the set 4 times. So you're gonna have 16. You're gonna hit 16 putts, but each set you're gonna have a different stroke. On the first set, you're gonna putt with your right hand only. Second set, it'll just be left hand only. Third set, you're gonna look at the hole. Fourth set, eyes closed. My personal best is 11, and I'm just gonna try to break that every time. So first set, right hand only. My least favorite putt is right downhill with a right to left break. So I made 2 in that set. This set, left hand only. If you practice these different putts enough, when you get on the course, you'll be able to have every putt in the book. Your putting will be a lot better. So right now I'm at 5. In this set, you're going to be looking at the hole while you putt with both hands. Feels a pull. So that said, I only made 1. 6. So eyes closed this time. So I made 7 putts. So I'm just gonna do it again and try to have a better score. First set again, right hand only. Left hand. So I'm only at 3. It's terrible. Hole in this set. Eyes closed. So 7 again. The eyes closed one is, it gets you excited because I just keep my eyes closed for the whole putt and just listen. If I hold it, I just think it's builds up tension. 7 again. It's not very good. So I'm gonna do it again. Is okay with the one-handed putts. What? One-handed right with the right hand only? That seems to be what I'm best at in this drill. So I beat it last time score. Now, it's springtime, so my dad and I just got hay fever. So if you couldn't really understand some of what I was saying, it's because of that. But now, I'm just gonna do like one set, just normal putting, and see if I make a hole. Thank you. 3, so the stroke definitely feels better, as it should, by doing that a lot, but that's just one of the drills I do for putting. Now, I really like the comments that I get on some of my videos, just saying like how you've lowered your handicap just because of some of the drills that I show you. But just feel free to comment on if this helps or not. I would love to know so I can do more of these and hopefully lower that even more. Putting, which I just showed you the drill. Then I get onto the range and I start off with shortest club and go upwards. So I start off with wedges. The first flag there is 89 yards. So I hit into the wind, I hit a sand wedge. I hit about, until I feel comfortable, I hit about 30 balls, 20 balls. Takes me about 10-15 balls to get warmed up with the wedge, then I'll be able to stick it. So now I'm going to move on to the next club. My rangefinder's getting old. I've had it for 3 years. Next flag is 115 yards, so I'm going to hit my gap wedge. There's no wind right now.
What's the amount of dip that you got going on, buddy? You really dipped down on that light Dustin Johnson. Yeah, sometimes you just have a tendency of really dipping down, and there's nothing wrong with it. Like, players like Dustin Johnson have a lot of dip. But ideally, you want to try and not overdo it. It's a big fallacy. A lot of people think that your head's supposed to stay still. Well, it can't possibly.
So as you can see here in the last 10 minutes, the wind has picked up and it's right now it's coming this way from the right and into the breeze. So I'm going to try and work on a little cut, low cut with the wedge. Right now, I'm trying to work it against the wind so it finishes straight. And I hit those two perfect with the amount of cut I want. So now I'm done with my gap wedge. I'm gonna go to the next leg, which is 160. So I'm gonna hit my 8-iron. Three. Those last three all went in the same spot left. So I'm gonna try work on a baby cut. The way I get a baby cut is I just aim a little left and then just swing a little bit inside out, and it just creates like a 5-yard cut. Later. Guess what came in the mail today?
What?
I'll let the people comment on what came in the mail today. The next part is a driver. I'm gonna hit about 80 balls with it. Well, right after I hit, I clean my club because if I leave it out for too long, it can stay in there. So I like to keep it fresh and clean. Anyways, moving on. My next club is a 5-iron to the 200-yard yellow flag out there.
Watch the draw, buddy.
That was about 3 feet right of the flag.
Pretty impressive. think you're trying to hit it a bit too hard?
No, I hit the last two like 3 feet. I'm gonna hit my 4-iron now, just because I need to hit it. I like my 4-iron because I hit it solid, it goes far, it goes low, and it's hard to miss hit. I hit this strike though, look. Sometimes when my dad's phone goes off, I feel like taking it and smashing it into a million pieces, but thankfully it never goes off on the course. Now I'm done with this 4-iron, so I'm gonna go to my hybrid. Now, I'm not even sure if I'm gonna be hitting my hybrid in the tournament, but I practice with it anyways, just in case I need it. Dad, can you do me a big favor? Like, it's a huge favor.
Get a drink.
Can you get me a pyramid?
Yeah.
After I smoke this one down the middle.
Yeet! Take a look at these nuts.
You haven't finished those ones yet.
Now my hybrid, it probably goes about 220. My 4-iron goes about 210, my 5-iron goes 200, my 5-wood goes 225, my 3-wood goes 240, my driver goes 270.
Work on your shot shape. Nice.
Now I'm going to move on to my 5-wood.
So why would you choose 5-wood over your 3-hybrid?
What?
Why would you choose, when you're choosing your clubs, why would you choose your 5-wood when it only goes 5 yards more than your hybrid?
I don't know.
Is that because you feel comfortable with the 5-wood?
I feel more comfortable with the hybrid.
Okay.
I'm going to use the hybrid in the tournament.
Okay.
Screw the 5-wood.
You got your 3-wood now?
5.
Oh, 5-wood, sorry.
I might just hit a couple.
Okay. You might use the 5-wood a few times into the par 5s.
How does that look? I'm gonna hit these off the tee because I don't really need to hit them off the deck at the tournament, so tees only.
Happened there?
It hurts my toe.
Your right toe?
Yeah.
Is that because your weight's posting on your left leg?
Yeah. My weight posted on my left leg there. Great job. Today about 250. I'm heading further today, and whenever I'm up here, because it's higher above sea level up here, it's about 2,000 feet above sea level. That's what, it was 1,756 above sea level when I checked up at the parking lot. But it just makes a difference with the how far it goes. Also up here, it runs a lot more than down in Hilton Head because it's wet down there. Here it just runs. Now I'm going to hit my driver because I'm hitting the group in the 3-wood. So, judging by what I just said, that should mean my driver should go 300. behind me. Now my right toe is hurting. I don't know why. I guess when I drag through, and then when it's like that, it's just putting a little bit of pressure on it. So I'm just gonna nurse it. Get a few more. Not try to put as much weight on it, but see what I can do. I found the way.
Looks funny. You can wrap it up now if you want.
Alright, last one. This is my last shot. After this shot, I'm gonna go over there and hit bunker shots and chip. Not doing that doesn't look great. But if it gets the job done, whatever gets you through the night. Here you guys might see that I've got about 5 feet of green to work with. So it's all about me popping the ball up and getting it to sit.
Need to see a lot more knee bend, bud. A lot more. Need a bit more height. Having a sand shower. Getting covered in sand, the wind's just blowing all the sand straight back onto him. It's quite hilarious, really. Gotta laugh. Really open that blade up, bud. It's still not quite open.
Is it open now?
Yep. Short of being perfect. That's why it's better to wear a hat sometimes rather than a visor. We'll pay that one. Carl's got a hair full of sand. He's going to be wishing he'd worn a hat rather than a visor. Hit the flag again, did him a disservice. See, he opened his blade up a bit more that time. The blade's really open. Okay, I think that's all you're going to do because of the wind, right?
Yeah.
You don't really like getting a head full of sand.
No.
So what about some touchy-feely shots from off this thick grass near the green? Do you want to tell us what you're going to do?
Now that I've done the bunker shower, I'm going to do some touchy-feely shots from just off the green. This here is one of the hardest shots in golf. It's a flop with barely any green. To play this shot in the rough, you need to open your club face, but make sure you don't decelerate on it. If you decelerate on it, it just goes straight under. So you got to accelerate through the ball, but not, you got, another thing is you have to have a lot of takeaway. If you have no takeaway but accelerate, it's just going to go like that too. So you have a long takeaway to build up momentum so it hits the ball with acceleration. So it lifts like this. Now when you're like this, you don't need to do it. You can just do a regular chip. It's not much to it. This again is a normal chip. And what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna hit that ball as short in the hole. See? That's my recovery shots from really spongy lies around the green. It's a shot you can't just learn overnight, you gotta build up practice with it. But eventually you'll be good enough at it to be able to pull it off on the course. Now, every range session is not the same. If I did the same range session I did just then, every day, it would be boring. And the things that change are just wind conditions, the drills I do on the chipping and putting green, and I practice a lot more of what I might be using for the next tournament I have. So it's not the same every time. It all just works around what I just did. This is just it. So hope you enjoyed the video.